Make your jokes, so Ian. Bellin don't sound like he's playing. Never heard Bellin.
Sharpen
like
your
this.
Knife, baby. Here's what I expected from Hostbuster. I figured he would either go, "Yeah, I did it. Go fuck yourself." That was an acceptable answer. Or he'd be like, "Yeah, I was turned up on lean at the time, but remember I quit drinking. And, you know, I'd never do that now." I expected one of those two things. And instead I got defensive, evasive behavior. Which means
why
he feels guilty
does
about
he
that
need
shit.
To have, why does he need to have one of those answers? Why are those the only two acceptable answers? Why did he have to be drunk, gone lean to make that phone call? What was wrong with that phone call? What did he do wrong?
No, I would have accepted, "Yeah, I did it because it was funny." That would have been a fine answer. But he didn't do that because he's turtling back and forth. He doesn't know how he feels about it.
And he kind of did say that, but you kept calling him a disingenuous piece of shit for so long that he started trying to explain himself to this guy that he thought was his friend.
I am his friend. I am your friend.
Not anymore, apparently. Apparently, you're blocked.
You don't get to decide when our friendship is over. I'll let you know. Ask Nick
I'm not
what
blocked.
It's like to not be my friend anymore.
I just don't understand what Hostbusters did to have to apologize for to Redgar.
Well,
why was he such an amoral piece of shit?
Because
that
he made a video.
You non-ironically called him a scumbag.
You're making that decision. Art is subjective. He made a video saying the tape doesn't exist. And then it turned out the tape did exist. So we wanted to call him out just for being a fucking liar. What's going on, Hostie? I thought you were telling the truth. I thought you were a truth teller. You don't roll around these true crime streets with us?
But Redbar said that he made a call threatening him. And Hostbusters never made a call threatening him. He made a call being funny to him. Messing around with him, saying, "I know
he was being funny."
Something that Redbar says to people
funny.
All the time. Well, he did it on his show.
Well,
why?
Really.
Here's what I don't
say,
why does Redbar, a guy who you don't know, just get to say this is what happened and it happened exactly that way? But Hostbusters, a guy you know a lot better than Redbar, who you've talked to a lot more than Redbar, comes on and says this is what happened, and you go, "That's not good enough. You're a piece of shit. Apologize. Grovel in front of our mutual audience for me."
Ian doesn't care.
Amusement.
Because Ian doesn't care about the truth. He cares about who's more popular and who might help him more. Sell out.
Ian, comment.
Red Bar's gonna sign me.
He's selling out for Red Bar.
I would never expect Red Bar to help me in any way, shape, or form ever for any reason.
There's
nothing in this for me. If anything, I put my neck in the noose to get made fun of more.
Mm-hmm.
And I
sure,
did that
bud.
For my good friend, Hostbuster. Because I wanted
sure,
to see
bud.
Him exonerate himself. I wanted to lose. I don't want to be this good at what I do. You should have beat me up, Hostie. Come on, take... I did something that got your attention? Isn't that better than shit that didn't get your attention? I'm done arguing with the commenters.
I think that might be all the relevant comment.
He's just
fitting a few games in. He's just getting in a couple rounds. Some kill confirmed.
Well, if...
Hey. Was that up?
I said the white man marches on.
It is on. Oh, I guy with the hair lip. I can't believe they let a guy with a hair lip, like, eat their crew, too.
Oh, bro, that's Mike Hammer, dude. That's fucking Stacey Keach. You gotta have Mike Hammer in there.
No,
okay.
Of course not.
Then I say it's not rape. Maybe.
And don't mind unless you drove 90 fucking miles. You probably drove, like, down the street. Don't mind.
Oh, man.
So, to be 100% honest, though, would you let Hostie back in your...
going anywhere? Is there an overarching plot?
I thought I was getting interviewed.
Kenny.
Is it overarching or overarching?
What are you, the American Dream podcast? Kenny, focus and ask Cheese a question.
What's your all-time favorite band?
What?
Like he gets sad too, like he's torturing himself.
Okay, I guess I'll do another interview. It's not my night for interviews.
So right in the middle of the interview, you're making fun of my questions.
Kenny, let her answer.
What was the question?
All right, I know when to shut up. Yeah, that's right.
What is your all-time favorite band?
I do a podcast on anchor.fm and you can see it. We talk plaid. Say who's Ian Ellis. Yeah, that's right.
So I'm old school and I like Mariah Carey, and it's not a band.
You're like a 90s thought.
Mm-hmm.
You're a 90s thought. You're a hoe in a crop top. But you straighten your hair. You put makeup.
Yeah, Mariah Carey.
No makeup. Makeup.
You an Alicia Keys ass bitch.
Hey. Yeah, they're all right.
What's your idea of looking cute when you go out?
This ain't your interview, motherfucker. Kenny, next question.
Okay, what's your idea of looking cute when you go out?
Thank you.
No. I like a dress sometimes on stream. It colors, maybe skirt, my hair. I don't put makeup on though.
Well, you feel like your legs are nice.
You make sure to cover your magical pussy. Yeah, that's great.
We wanted to be RDA, Noel and I, and we never made it. And I didn't like it. Because I asked Ross from... He lives like, I would say right now, 11,000 miles away.
Yo, guys, is that D.D. Dugan?
How do you know who D.D. Dugan is?
Yeah,
we don't know.
What's your basis, bro?
I just come up with shit, Kenny. Let the rest deal with it, you know?
Rev knows he ugly mafugly. That's right.
Rev, turn your camera, babammer.
Everyone has their camera on. Yep.
You're like, everyone has their camera on except Rev the fucking.
Rev,
pussy.
You asshole. We know you're ugly. You're ugly.
We know you have bad teeth.
Just turn it on. Jesus Christ.
I don't want to.
Seriously.
I don't want to.
Not a bitch. Part of the community.
I'm not in the mood tonight, you fucking little girl.
Why are you so demanding?
I didn't put my makeup on today. What are you doing?
Don't be mad. Just turn it on. It's the easiest thing.
I don't even have
ever.
A camera.
Yes, you do. You turned it on last time.
Your phone has. Faggot.
I'm just watching the couple of
Just like Red, I'm just gonna find out Kenny's real life and destroy everything he's built.
Right? No. Kenny has actually built something though. He has his own apartment. You know,
yeah, that's true.
He's got stuff to actually lose. Red has nothing to lose.
Nothing at all.
You're right. He really should just be robbing people, Cosmic. Like, what the fuck else does he have to lose?
And he doesn't want to show his face. Like, they're gonna figure out who I am, bud. Like, why are they gonna ruin Red? You have nothing.
He couldn't rob his dead mother.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's right.
I caught anybody catch Lemonade's video yesterday. She was talking
about it. Wendy.
Hey. I've been sitting on this since that thing you sent me.
Yeah. I caught it. I caught it.
Hey, Andy. I haven't forgot about you.
Hey, Wendy.
Hey, Wendy.
Would that be okay, Helen?
Great, dude. I'm gonna be honest, I thought it was gonna be dud too. I really did. And then like 2 hours, 3 hours in, I was like, oh, there we go, and then it worked.
Andy, Andy, I caught it. I put comment.
That was great. Thank you.
Jamie, you're a coward. Why don't you go live and face us? Yeah, that's right. She won't. She is coward. That's right.
I don't think she's listening, Kenny.
Maybe. She may be.
Don't just tell her to
come on, when you turn your camera on, you pussy.
We are no longer
yes.
Hurting our
knee. You know, Red is a pussy. You'll never show yourself on cam.
I don't even know.
Especially when you're there.
Yeah, that's right. I have to go get more water. I'll be right back.
Oh, get your thirsty ass out of here then, boy.
We're drinking beers. Drink beer.
$50,000 to jump off a bridge. Will you do it?
No.
Well, it depends on the bridge.
That won't cover the hospital bills.
Depends how high the bridge is.
Yeah, depends on what bridge it is.
Let Wendy ask the questions.
Yeah.
Hey, Cosmo, would you, if a girl offered you $20,000, would you go in a restaurant and walk in nude and ask for 30 cheeseburger and french fries?
I'll do that.
Hell yes.
I got a $2,000 fine. That's what I got.
Hell yeah.
Wendy, next question.
Yeah.
Wendy,
hello.
Go ahead.
Hello.
Go ahead.
Hey, Kenny, are you drinking wine tonight?
Yeah.
What kind of wine are you drinking?
I have to go get the bottle. Hold on.
But you have a bottle. It's not even on the
what kind of wine you drink.
Push a button.
Good night, Alan.
Since we added.
Where's cheesy? Where's the cheese?
Cosmo.
Kenny, shut up.
Cheesy.
Can I ask you a question?
Cheesy's been chilling for the.
Cosmic's in the house.
Horrible things. You might be like a mafioso from the Tartar. No.
Cutting off the power. I don't fucking know, bro.
What is it all for?
I don't believe you died.
You
can
call
it
a storm. Big storm. Big storm.
You're the last person I saw without a mask. That's it. Turn it off. Y'all thought I was playing?
Fucking combo.
Turn it off.
You could rename it Kenferty.
Kenferty. Yeah, we could. We could do that for you. Maybe tonight we'll do it. It'll be Kennedy.
Kennedy, some shit. We'll play some shit.
Kennedy
like
will ask all these questions that nobody knows the answer to.
How many Lucky Charms marshmallows are in a corner of a bowl? You're like, what?
That doesn't even. Oh,
that's a 6-2. Yeah. 6-2. Andy's right again.
Where's producer Jay?
Who do I kick off?
He'll be here, I'm sure. Jay. Hopefully he is.
But we lost energy, but it's like an internal energy, like a will to live.
Now, Cosmic, are you still doing your show, man? I haven't seen you, an episode from you in a minute. Are you doing it or what?
I did one a couple of days ago. It's always just so late night. That's the deal.
I crashed.
Andy asked me last episode we asked, and Andy asked if you ever been on, and I was like, nah, I don't think Donnie's ever come on my channel.
Yeah,
maybe I'd be going hella late in the comments section, maybe.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, I think going at like 1 a.m. and shit. I can't expect Donnie to be like, I'm gonna sneak in and fucking get the shit going.
No, sometimes I'll be up. But when you had like Campspiracies, I was on that.
Yeah. That was more reasonable.
That was during the day.
I ain't got no schedule like you guys. You guys are all scheduled.
Yeah, morning. No, it just depends, dude. Sometimes I'm up late, I can't fucking sleep, and I'll click on it. But it seems like usually when I can't sleep, nothing's on. I'm like, shirt on, you don't know the band. You guys just got
I know the band, dude. I named like 4 songs.
Joe disappeared, so we can bring him back because he's not there. So maybe Joe.
Say that was where I was going to. All right. Bye bye, Joe. We'll see you when you get back from the bathroom, whatever.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh. Yeah, that's right. Hey, Uncle Jeff, here he is.
Hey, Jeff, unmute yourself, Jeff.
Did you unmute yourself, Uncle Jeff?
Yeah, unmute yourself, dude.
He's still not there.
He's still got the bar.
What the fuck's wrong with you?
I got off the anybody knows sign language.
We were staring at the wing back. I missed the wing back chair.
Right. Where's Jay tonight? No producer Jay?
I don't know. I think he's out with his girl. There it is.
Who's you guys? What's up?
Empty chair.
Empty chair, that's right.
He's the most interesting motherfucker here. So anyways, what's going on, Johnny? What are you doing, man? You gonna come out and promote the show tonight? Are you gonna fucking really show us your commitment?
Hey, Joe.
Johnny! What the fuck?
What's up, man? Cut it out, bro.
You can't hear me?
No, this internet sucks.
Can you hear me now, Johnny, with your disco ball? And
yeah, it really does.
It still says start.
I hear you, brother.
He's too busy dancing on the dance floor.
Listen, Johnny.
Look at that disco ball.
We need you to fuck. He thinks it's 78.
I just barbecued it up. Barbecued some steaks.
You still be okay?
Nice.
Look here.
What's up?
I didn't touch your coolie. That's right.
How you been, Johnny? He's out of commission.
Yeah, he's
just chilling, bro, in man cave, man.
It is. Oh, there he is. What's up, John? Listen, go put your mask on. We got to bang on some doors.
Comment, and I was just reacting off that. That's all.
If I make a side comment, you're gonna fucking unload on me for 20 minutes because I'm scared.
Jeff didn't sport that Hitler mustache, did he?
No, he didn't do it, man. You've been doing good, Jay. No. You working and shit. Everything been cool?
Yeah.
Jay's still trying to make a move on his landlord. You bang your landlord yet?
No, not yet.
Knock off a month's rent.
He said, no, not yet.
I need to. I probably need to bang like the not whole yet. Office staff at this point.
Why is that?
That's a lot of banging.
It would help with rent.
It would help you figure out. Oh, yeah. You've been pretty busy, though, right? They're keeping you working a lot, eh?
Yes and no.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been just barely like getting, I haven't been getting 40 hours, like just shy of it usually.
Oh, they're cutting your hours down.
Yeah, it's just like not work here and there. So,
yeah. You used to get a lot of time and a half and shit, right? When you'd be on call.
Yeah, not this job, not so much. It wasn't really hard to get 40 hours before all this. Now, you know, all this shit happened, but now it's a little more complicated.
Now, do you still work with Ross or no?
No.
Okay, I thought you guys worked together.
That's been a while that we haven't.
Yeah. Yeah, that was right when Frankie was going to come move down there and you guys were going to start a handyman service, right?
Yeah, I mean, we weren't even working together at that point, so, but yeah.
Yeah, Frankie is now a motivational speaker. I don't know if you know that or not.
Bill Cosby. No, but say the statement. Again. I thought you said he drove by her.
Okay. He is a German lady. Really wish this didn't exist.
So, I don't know who Milky popular. Lemonade is, but I can be privy to this information.
Of course not. How would we ever know?
One of the videos happened to be taken down. It's got a total of two videos taken down, but guess what? No strikes. No strikes.
No, and, you know what? I had you know two taken down on my backup channel. Them?
Mm-hmm. We uploaded them and took out one or two pictures.
That's what I
mean. And won an appeal on the first one she got taken down. So I don't know how I know this stuff.
I put up two. I put up two on my backup channel. Online harassment. And they both got taken down, and she was really proud of it. She said it in one of the probably in the Nary RDA rejects gang gangs.
I saw a comment somewhere. Yeah. I actually took a screenshot. It was on the YouTube video. That she was bragging about, oh, I struck that video and took it down.
Well, no strike.
Because she says flaggings for a still fucking faggot. Still own the video. Up there.
Yeah. She and it's all going to be the stream. Basically, that live stream I did from the backup channel, I'm going to have to start over and do it again now. I see no other option but to just go live eventually and do the same exact video again.
Aggro, that's what I was going to say earlier. So, we might be able to finally move away from these true crime, old, nasty, fucking...
I thought
I say old. I can't emphasize old enough. Robbie,
the last one.
What's true crime?
I mean,
the last true crime lady, Robbie.
We can go back to our original mission, because I think our old buddy, I'm an Asian guy, is back. You see his video?
He went away.
No, he's back.
No, he's not. Hell, he's
been
gone for months.
Hell, am I stupid?
Look, that Filipino asshole who says he's a Korean.
I'm an Asian guy.
I'm an Asian guy.
What are they talking about?
I prefer to brand the label Korean.
I'm an Asian guy.
Filipinos can be kind of first
class. Get first class Asians.
Filipino.
Sorry, Sam Hill.
Oh, High Number's in the chat. I would love if High Number could tell us about the love breakup, the back and forth with Sam Hill. Because there's definitely some sort of...
I know most of us here don't like High Number for good reason, but I've been enjoying his comments on some videos lately.
I just want to know what
happened. I always lumped him in with Vice Versa and Jackson Black and shit.
Hate Saving Robbie. I hate Saving Robbie too now.
Is he not...
He's not as bad as those guys.
Little Robbie can blow me. One faggot.
Just because he hangs out with Kyle doesn't mean he's as bad as Vice Versa. Jesus. And Jackson Black. He's a little bit
worse.
I put High Number in more of a category of a Tom and an AOC. That's why. I just said that.
How dare you. Tom earmuffs.
Okay. Tom is up there. AOC. I can agree AOC and High Number.